What's up internet, I am Manish from rebellionwriter.com. Welcome to the second tutorial on Python print function. Here we will discuss the fourth parameter of the Python print function, which is file. Here I will show you how to save the output of the Python print function into a file. As this tutorial is in the continuation of the last one, thus I suggest you to watch that tutorial first for a confusion-free journey. That being said, let's start today's tutorial. But before we start, give this video a thumbs up. Also, help me in reaching to 100k subscribers by subscribing to my channel if you haven't already. Now, let's start. By default, the Python print function is designed to show the output on the standard output stream, which is almost always the screen of your computer. For example, here I have two print function calls. The first one is set to print a string and the second one contains a mathematical expression. If I execute them, they will show us the output on our screen like this. Here is the output displayed to us on our screen. There is nothing wrong with this output, but question here is, will this output retain itself for reuse if we do some changes in the function call? For example, let's say I'm doing some comparison analysis and in that I want to change this multiplication factor from 12 to 12.5. Let's see the output now. See, here we got the output. Although it's correct, but we lost the previous output. Now that we have lost the previous output, we cannot reuse it for comparison. This demonstration proves that the Python print function call shows the correct output on the default output stream, but that output is volatile. Thus, we cannot reuse it. We just saw the problem with the default Python print function call. Now, let's come to the solution. Wouldn't it be awesome if we could somehow modify the output stream from printing the output on the screen to saving the output into a file permanently? That would solve our problem, right? My dear friend, we can do that using the fourth parameter of Python print function, which is file. So right now, our aim is to redirect the default output stream from showing the output on the screen to saving it into a file. For the demonstration, we will use the first Python print function call. This time, we will try to save this string into a file rather than showing it onto the screen. Let's do that. For this demonstration, I have created a folder with name Python tutorials in my document directory. This folder will be my current project directory. Inside this folder, I will be creating a Python script with the name tut20.py. You can create your script and folder wherever you want and name them whatever you want. Now, I will open this script with Atom Editor. Here we go. Now, let's write some code. Here I created a variable and named it file name. Into this variable, we are storing a file object. On the right hand side of the assignment operator, we have a function called open. Open is another inbuilt function of Python library, which does exactly as its name suggests. This function opens a file and returns its file object. File object is an object which lets you read, write, and append data into a file. In case the file which you have specified does not exist, then this function will create one for you. This function takes two string type parameters. First parameter is the name of the file. Here you can either specify just the name of the file or name of the file with its location path. In my case, I have only specified the name of the file, which is demofile.txt. It is always recommended to write the name of the file with its extension. It's a good practice. When you only specify the name, like I did here, then this function first looks for the file in the directory of your current project, which in my case is Python tutorials. If it finds the file, then it will open it Otherwise, it will create a new file in that directory. Second parameter which it takes is open mode. This is the mode into which this function opens the files for you. The most common open modes are W. W stands for write. In this mode, the file will be open in the write only mode. R. R stands for read. In this mode, the file will be open in read only mode. And the third one is A. A stands for append. This is the mode which I am using here. In this mode, the function will open the file and append the data to the end of the file. Mind here, if you open the file in write mode, then the interpreter will delete all the previously saved data of that file. Like these three open modes, there are four other modes. I have explained those in detail in a dedicated blog. You can find the link in the description. Now let's move ahead and complete this code. So far, this is the same print function call which we have performed before. Now we have to add the file parameter into it. That's all we have to do. As I have not created the demo file.txt file, thus on execution, the interpreter will create one for me in current project directory. In addition, it will save the output of this Python print function into that. Let's execute and see the result. See, there is no output on the screen this time. Now let's go to my project directory and check if we have demo file.txt file there with our output or not. Here we are. Here we also have the demo file.txt file. Let's open it and check if it has the output from our print function saved into it or not. Here we got the string. That's how we redirect output stream and save the output of the Python print function into a file. Now let's come back to our Python print program. Great. Done. Mind here, this redirection of the output stream is temporary, which means if you write a print statement without the file parameter next to the one which we just wrote, the output of that Python print function will get displayed onto the screen. Let me show you. Here I just added another Python print function call. On execution, the output of the first print function will get appended into file, but the output of this second print function will get displayed on your screen. Let's check. See, here we got the output. That's exactly what I meant when I said the redirection of the stream to a file is temporary. Stay tuned, as in the next tutorial we will learn how to redirect the output stream and save the output of all the Python print function call permanently. That's the tutorial on how to write into a file using Python print function. Hope you enjoyed watching. If so, then please hit the thumbs up button. Also, share this video on your social media with your friends. Most importantly, I want to hit 100k this year, so please subscribe. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionWriter.com.